Good morning. I tell you, I've got a ritual going on. Get up before sun, get up before the sun comes up, get my cup of coffee, get the bread of life, and that starts my day off. And I can't think of no better way to do it. But I got something that I want to share with you. Tonight at sunset we'll be going to Shavuot, and very, very significant. It was on Shavuot that the Torah was given on Mount Sinai. It was on Shavuot that the 120 was in the upper room when the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, descended and remained upon the earth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. From my own personal experience, there's a lot going on. There's a lot of people going through some issues. There's a lot of people that are struggling, including Erica and myself, that it's like we're in the furnace. We're in the heat of the battle. And I woke up this morning. I've been awake since about 4:30. And I woke up thinking about this here. And I just did a post a few minutes ago about, the closer we get to the feast date, the High Sabbaths, the more intensified the battle's going to become, the attacks will become more aggressive. And I just want to encourage you, don't give up. Don't let something that's going to be temporarily rob you of your victory. Don't let it rob you of your joy, because this storm's going to run out of rain. This storm's going to run out of rain eventually. Sometimes when you're going through a battle, it feels like you're isolated, but I want to assure you that you are not the only one that feels like you're in the furnace. Being in the furnace is a good thing. It may not feel like it. It may not look like it, but it's a good thing. Because I think about when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was cast into the furnace. The only thing that was burned was the cords that had them bound. We can allow the trials in the furnace to refine us, draw us closer to the Father. But I got a word for you. In 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 12, he said, "Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you. But rejoice, inasmuch as ye are partakers of the Messiah's sufferings, that when his glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy." I'm going to tell you what I'm telling myself. Dig deep into the word. Dig deeper than you ever have. Regardless of how you feel, regardless of what's happening in the natural, regardless of the deficit, continue to offer that sacrifice of praise to the Father. Continue to praise Him. Your victory will come. Your breakthrough will manifest. He who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. Elohim has got your back. Be blessed. Until the next time, much shalom.